Hello and welcome to our guideline videos for healthcare professionals. In this first part of the series of videos, we are going to have an in-depth comparative review regarding Australian Medical Council, AMC and Professional and Linguistic Assessment Board, PLAB exam for UK, which has recently changed to United Kingdom Medical Licensing Assessment, UKMLA or MLA exam. This comparative review includes discussing many basic key factors for AMC and PLAB, or UKMLA exam, like general overview, as well as eligibility criteria of both of these licensing exams. Because of the recent changes, this review will surely help aspiring candidates to understand these two medical licensing exams and work in these two countries, UK or Australia. This is Dr. Muhammad from Interface Medical Education, and I will try to discuss AMC and PLAB medical licensing exams in a comparative manner, so keep watching this video till the end. I am sure that you will be able to understand many things related to AMC and PLAB exam. Before starting this video, we would also like to invite you to watch many of our videos made for healthcare professionals. I will request you guys to subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon to enjoy more of such informative videos in future, and of course, if you like this video then, do not hesitate to hit the like button and send us your valuable comments. So, let's get started now. Doctors who are willing to pursue their career in UK and Australia need to pass PLAB or AMC exam respectively. There can be many influencing factors convincing you to migrate to these or any other European country, especially when you are an international medical graduate, IMG. We have covered many such factors in one hour video, helping you to make up your mind for any such country. We have provided this video link here, as well as in the description section. Generally, PLAB and AMC exams are conducted in English and consist upon two parts each. PLAB has been recently transitioned into UKMLA or MLA exam, which is United Kingdom Medical Licensing Assessment, making it more standardised medical licensing exam, quite similar to US MLE steps. Now, all medical graduates, let it be IMGs or UK or EU graduates passing out in 2024 or onward, required to sit for this new exam. Unlike with PLAB system, where local graduates or medical graduates coming from EU countries or Switzerland were exempted from PLAB exam. This was the decision which has created many problems in the UK medical system, as currently reflected in the doctors' crisis in UK, with UKMLA, GMC UK, is planning to overcome such crisis situation. On the other hand, we are seeing recently significant increase in the number of international medical graduates applying for Australian Medical Council exam, AMC. You can follow different available assessment pathways, like standard, competent or specialist pathway, based upon your fulfillment of eligibility criteria for AMC registration, enabling you to practice medicine legally in Australia. We have separately covered standard and competent pathways in two of our separate videos. We have provided the link here as well as in the description section. Applicant must meet the following eligibility criteria to sit for PLAB or AMC exam. First, for either of the exam, your medical school must be listed in the WHO, which is World Directory of Medical Schools listing. For AMC, your medical degree should be verified by ECFMG, which is United States Education Commission for Foreign Medical Graduates. You can check your medical school eligibility through selecting your country and making sure that your medical school's name is available in the recognized institutions list. Additionally, ensure that your degree name is also recognized. For PLAB, your medical degree conferred by your medical school should also be acceptable by General Medical Council, GMC UK. For AMC, you must have passed IELTS, OIT and PT Academic, which is computer-based tests conducted at testing centre. For PLAB, you must demonstrate that you have sufficient speaking and writing skills to be able to smoothly practice in the UK healthcare system, therefore you need to pass Occupational English Test, OET, or International English Language Testing System, IELTS test. Another usually overlooked point is about completing internship or house job before appearing in any of these exams. For AMC provisional registration or for PLAB, GMC registration, you must have completed 1 year internship or house job in your home country or in the country from where you obtained your medical degree. That's all from us for this part of the video. In the next parts of this series, we will be exploring important information for AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exams, like comprehensive details regarding both exams' content, passing criteria, how and when to register, and attempts allowed, as well as details regarding required English proficiency exams, total expenses, job opportunities, and salary structure for doctors working in these two counties. So for all these exclusive upcoming videos, stay tuned to our channel. Hopefully this video will be beneficial for you and may have clarified many of your questions related to many key points for AMC and PLAB or UKMLA exams, especially before relocating to Australia or UK. Do not forget to watch many of our videos made for healthcare professionals. Hopefully you may have liked this video, then do not forget to hit the like button. Share, comment and subscribe to our channel. Have a good day, bye.